Hola, yo soy Hugo Bravo, estás en Doxal.com y el día de hoy estamos en el Centro Cultural Pedregal en la Ciudad de México y tenemos con nosotros a Grisha Stewart. Hello, Grisha.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Thank you for coming to Mexico.
Oh, my pleasure, it's been great.
Bueno, Grisha es adiestradora profesional certificada. Ella es autora de un libro llamado BAT 2.0 y ella desarrolló este método de adiestramiento. Grisha, what is BAT 2.0?
BAT is a technique that I developed to help dogs gain confidence and social skills. So we use it to help dogs who are showing, you know, growling or barking or running away, and even puppies, that to prevent that problem, helping them gain confidence and be able to function in society.
As trainers, we mostly used to try to have the control of the dog all the time. Mm-hmm. But you say that the control, they have to have the control.
Mm-hmm. So in order for the dogs to be able to sort of heal their own reactivity, we need to create situations where they feel safe, so they have the control of that situation. We micromanage the situation and not the dog, and that way we don't have to micromanage them forever.
And this method is used for aggressive dog or behavior problems with dogs, but it's also for puppies. So how do we use this method on those different kind of dogs?
So the basic idea of BAT is that we sort of create a scenario or a situation where they can be comfortable. And so with puppies, they're more comfortable in a variety of situations where they're not a danger to the public or anything like that. So we manage their space a little carefully, but not so much for the safety of others, but for their own mental safety. And when we're working with dogs who have aggression problems, then we need to also make sure that they're not hurting anybody else. And so we tend to use more long lines, so like a 5-meter leash, to be able to keep them from getting to something that makes them feel uncomfortable. Because when they feel uncomfortable, they start showing aggression.
And you made this differentiation mm-hmm. about BAT and the usual training that we made. Mm-hmm. What is this difference and how do you work with BAT and the usual training?
So by usual training, you mean positive training still?
Yes.
Yes,
of course.
That's the right way, right?
Yeah.
Those two I do combine. I wouldn't combine it with more punishment, kind of military training. But and I say military, but really it's not even military. In the military, a lot of times they use positive training too, but it's sort of the old-fashioned military. So BAT is really the socialization part. And the standard clicker training part is about getting specific behavior that we want, and also other kinds of positive training, so do as I do or whatever else. But so we kind of combine it. So we use positive reinforcement when we want to get a specific skill, and we use this BAT way of creating freedom to create social dogs.
Okay, as trainers, we don't use much the adjective to the aggressive dog, mm-hmm. we use more reactive dog. Mm-hmm. Why do we use it?
I would change it even a little bit more. So I tend to use a label that applies to the behavior and not the dog. So I would say reactive behavior or a dog with reactivity problems. So I wouldn't say the dog, I wouldn't say reactive dog because that sort of implies that we can't change it, the dog's behavior. But aggression is intent to do harm. And most of the time, dogs are not aggressive. They're actually just trying to communicate something, which is, I need space away from that thing that scares me. So reactivity is basically over-reactivity, meaning that the dog is showing more behavior than we would expect, a stronger behavior. But that would still be reasonable in that situation. It's just the amount of it is too much. So aggression is intent to do harm. And most dogs are not actually out to really injure other dogs, although certainly aggression is a type of reactivity, but not all reactivity is aggression, if that makes sense.
And what about the other behavior?
Also fear and running away is part of reactivity as well, and frustration. So when the dog is overly excited to get to something and they're barking and lunging at the leash and whatever, that's also reactivity.
And how can we avoid or prevent these behaviors, these unwanted behaviors?
The main thing is to socialize a puppy when they're young, so get them to have positive experiences with other people, with dogs, with you know, vacuum cleaners and skateboards and all the things that they might encounter in their life. And really kind of thinking ahead in terms of your lifestyle. So sometimes people get a dog and then have children later, but they haven't introduced their dogs to children while the dog was a puppy in the household. And so that's an example. But basically, the style of training of BAT that we do, of letting them explore and check things out and have the power to choose to move away from something that scares them, is really important. So especially that last piece, I think a lot of people push dogs into situations and say, I'm socializing you, when really the ability to have curiosity and check something out and move away when they want to is really better socialization.
Yeah, it's very interesting. So anyone who wants to learn more about this, they can buy your book. Mm-hmm. And it's also in Spanish?
Yes.
Yes, cool. And tell me, this method, and you as a developer of this method, mm-hmm. Worldwide, why don't you have a TV show?
Well, I think I probably don't have a TV show for a whole number of reasons, but one of them is because BAT is really casual and not super exciting. It's just about dogs having a really good time exploring the world. So I don't know. I'd love to have a TV show, but I don't think it would be as exciting as people would. There's no fighting and biting and mean stuff because we set the dogs up for success.
Yes, that's what you were saying, that TV shows is drama.
Yeah, that's right.
So we don't want drama. We want
happy dogs.
Yes, yeah. Of course. Thank you very much, Grisha, for having this interview.
Thanks for having me.
I hope we meet one day soon.
I hope so, too. Take care.
Thank you very much. Gracias por estar con nosotros. Si les gusta este video, ya saben qué hacer con él. Denle like, compartan y nos vemos la próxima.